What's going on, everybody? Thank you for coming to my channel. Welcome to my page. This morning, I woke up and I heard the devastating news that Traci Braxton has passed on. I was really, really sad to hear that news because I really admired Traci. I thought she was really strong and just somebody who fought for her dreams, and just I really admired her. I admired that no matter what happened, she had always been fighting for what she believed in, and she was strong, and she reached her goal. She actually had a song on the music charts on Billboard Top 100s that went to number 16. So I was really happy for her that she was making her way in the industry the way that she wanted to, after having some disappointments and just not really achieving the goals that she thought she wanted to achieve at a younger age. So it was nice to see, after she had kids and she got married and things, you know, worked out. She was on a reality show and then she actually released music. So I was really, really happy for her, you know, just kind of as an artist, admired that. You know, I admired that she never gave up. I admired that no matter what happened in her younger years with her sisters, because to my understanding, and you guys can correct me if I'm wrong, but she and her sisters had gotten a record deal, and then she got pregnant, and then she was like basically kicked out of the group or something. And then it was just like years of just, you know, she had chose motherhood, you know, and to see that later on in her life that she actually got a chance to achieve her goals, it's just very admirable and very inspirational. So I was very, very sad to hear that she was ill and that she fought for over a year battling cancer. That was very sad. And if you look at my page a couple of weeks ago, I'm showing my journey to health myself, because, you know, as we get older, we deal with hormone problems and just different elements start, stress and, you know, just things come in, and you have to make sure that you're following a certain diet and, you know, trying to do the best you can to be cancer free and be, you know, illness free. It's not easy, you know. So I was just really sad to hear about that, because I was a fan of the Braxton Family Values. I used to watch the show. If you look at my channel, I also did a video on Tamar Braxton when she had that suicide scare. So I'm pretty invested in the family, and just I love watching them. I think I admire, you know, just the fact that they're sisters and they're, you know, they're all very talented and very beautiful. So TMZ announced today, Toni Braxton took to Instagram and penned a heartfelt message saying, "It is with utmost regret that we inform you of the passing of our sister Traci. Needless to say, she was a bright light, a wonderful daughter, an amazing sister, a loving mother, wife, grandmother, and a respected performer. We will miss her." So she had been dealing with this illness for a year privately, undergoing a series of treatments for the cancer. So, you know, the thing is that I have to say, like, I'm a little bit torn when it comes to, and obviously it's none of our business, right? It's just a private thing. When it comes to celebrities struggling with cancer privately, I'm a little bit torn. Like, I kind of wish that it would be announced, like, during your journey, kind of just go public and say, "Hey, this is what's happening," because it's so shocking when someone you love and someone you admire and they're a big celebrity and you really love following their journey, it's so shocking when they die. Like, it's just like, wait, hold on a minute. I didn't know that you were sick. It's what happened with Chadwick Boseman for me. I mean, obviously it is none of our business. Let me just put that out there, that I know it's not my business. It's not my business. It's the personal choice of the person who's dealing with that struggle about whether or not they want to say anything. I'm just saying, like, as a fan, I wish that there was like little hints of it, like even so we could like support them and just say, "Hey, you know, we love you. We're praying for you. We want you to beat this." You know, it's just like, just as a person struggling by yourself and dealing with this. I mean, I know that for the last year and a half, like, I was always tired. I was always dealing with just fatigue and stress, and just obviously, thank God it wasn't cancer, but I was dealing with really like bad symptoms of not wanting to get out of bed and just really, really not healthy, right? And so I started fighting that with different diets and different treatment routines. You could check my page for that, for with red light therapy and sauna. And like, I just did everything I could. I did a full detox program for about 4 weeks, every day in the sauna, just really like detoxing and just really cleansing my body. And I just decided about certain foods I wasn't going to eat. And I'm feeling a lot better now. And I did share that journey, but I shared that journey like at the end when I started feeling better, because I was like not really feeling good about being on camera, or just felt bad about feeling bad, or just didn't want to like feed my haters, the people who hate me, who want to see me not doing well. I just didn't want to like feed them. So it's just like a very interesting thing when you get sick as a celebrity, or when you have some celebrity, it's like, I understand why some people wouldn't say anything, but I think also for the people who really, really love you, it's just sad that you could die all of a sudden and people are like, oh my God, like what happened, you know? So I just wanted to come on and just pay tribute to Traci. I really, really, really am sad to hear this. I think that 50 is young. I think that, you know, I think we should be given at least 100 years, right, on this planet, in this lifetime. So I think 50 is young to go. And she had a beautiful career and a beautiful family and people who loved her. And it's just, you know, it's one of those things where I just wish I could have helped, or I wish I could have done something to help her. You know, it's just very sad. And I just wanted to come back and just talk about that, and also just really, truly, I'm going to be showing my journey of weight loss and also a journey of holistic healing and just healthy living. I think that right now, especially during COVID, and people are really afraid, and just some people are still in their houses, especially in New York City, they just don't want to come outside. I think like it's just important that we start focusing on more natural healing. Sister Naira is someone that I really respect and admire, and she's selling sea moss and, you know, just going into more holistic foods and things that keep us healthy. Dr. Sabi was an amazing doctor who promoted the importance of holistic healing and natural foods and juicing and these things, that fasting, intermittent fasting, all of these things that we have to really delve into, especially now, because it's just so many bad foods and, you know, just things that are working against us with the 5G. And you could have your own idea about what those things are, but I've been kind of studying about it, and it's kind of scary stuff. So keep following my journey. Much love and respect to the Braxton family. I send you all my prayers and all my love and love and light to you. And you guys keep following, and thanks for listening. Have a great day.